This phrase was a serious warning to the Arabs. When the people gathered to hear the news, the Messenger of God addressed them and said,
O people, if I inform you that there is an army waiting outside the city to attack on your lives and property, will you trust me?
Obviously, we will trust you. You are truthful and honest.
We didn't see you lying or behaving badly with anyone.
O people, believe in one God alone and save yourself from the fire of hell. I am like a guard who sees the enemy from a distance and rushes to his people to save and informs them of the upcoming calamity.
Hearing this, the people became silent.
Woe to you, Muhammad. Muhammad, did you call us here to tell this nonsense? O people of Mecca, Muhammad has separated his path from us and our idols for 3 years, and he has misled a number of people. You people must be afraid that his religion may not cause anger and wrath from our gods. If the anger and wrath of idols did not cause rain in this city for a year, what will be your fate? Tell me, what will be the outcome? Go back to your homes. Go. Go to the Kaaba and sacrifice for the idols. I can see their anger with my own eyes. I see with my own eyes the signs of the idols' grief and anger. Go. Go. Sacrifice for them. What are you looking at my face standing here? Something has to be done very soon. Why not expel him from Mecca?
It is not an easy task to silence Muhammad. The problem is that Abu Talib, the chief of Bani Hashim, supports him. If Muhammad is harmed even a little, it will be our heads and the Bani Hashim with their naked swords.
So what's the choice? We can't sit doing nothing.
I will talk to Abu Talib. Abu Talib, I want to talk to you. Your nephew's intentions are dangerous. He speaks openly about the one and only God, cursing idols and our gods, and calling our ancestors misguided. Either command him or tell him to leave the pursuit of our gods, or you leave his support. Or hand him over to us so we can stop him ourselves.
What an unreasonable desire. I'll try to talk to him.
What happened, Abu Sufyan? Did Abu Talib talk to his nephew or not?
The Quraysh could not be more patient than to see Muhammad slander their gods and despise their beliefs. We offered him that we are ready to make him our master and to take all the wealth, on the condition that he relinquish his invitation and resume his normal life. Otherwise, we will take another route. Your support will not work this time. What was the result of your conversation with Muhammad?
I promised you people that I will talk to him and told him about your wish. Do you know what he said? Even if they put the sun on my right hand and the moon on my left hand, I will not give up my invitation at all, and try to achieve my goal until then. He will continue to do so until he overcome all the difficulties and achieve the ultimate goal, or in this way he loses his life. I swear by the God of Muhammad, Abu Sufyan, as long as I have life left in my body, I will not stop supporting him until he completes his mission. I think you got the answer to your question.
Muhammad has said that even if they put the sun on my right hand and the moon on my left hand, I will not give up my invitation. What does this mean?
The point is that all the wealth of the Arabs cannot force Muhammad to compromise with us.